The far-right House Freedom Caucus seems to be scheming for yet another government shutdown. And the way they're doing that is they are using their slim majority in the House of Representatives as leverage to play hardball and make all sorts of demands that, for now at least, the Democrats and the Biden administration claim are non-starters. Here's what you need to know about this impending hostage situation, which plays out over and over and over again. I'm kind of exhausted by these recycled stories, these recycled tactics, but nonetheless, here you go. So to keep the government funded, Congress needs to pass 12 yearly appropriations bills by September 30th. Now, so far, Congress has managed to pass one of those appropriation bills, which is not a good sign because currently the Senate is on recess. They don't even come back from recess until September 5th, and the House won't return until September 12th. I mean, do they do anything other than recessing and fundraising while they recess, of course?
No, it's really amazing. Hey, guys, do you all get August off? The entire month of August?
Insane.
Okay, like our legislators are like the French.
I don't even think the French, holidays as much as our members of Congress do.
Yeah, that might, yeah. But they took the English system for everyone else, the Britannical system where you have to all work 24/7. But for themselves, they took the French system, and then you're right, Anna, doubled it, tripled it, quadrupled it. I'm telling you, when I ran for Congress, I checked, they work only half the year. And then still Marjorie Taylor Greene comes out and goes, oh, they're making us work too hard. This is way too much.
Insane.
I can't even run my side hustles efficiently.
All right, so since things are looking pretty grim for the government funding bill, House Speaker Kevin McCarthy, a Republican, is trying to pass what's known as a stopgap bill. It's a continuing resolution to solve the issue, which will keep the government funded at the levels that they're currently at for a particular period of time. Now, McCarthy has not specified how long that period of time would be, but nonetheless, the House Freedom Caucus is essentially blocking that plan. And they're saying that in order to get their votes for this continuing resolution, they would need to get some of their demands met. Now, what are those demands? Of course, they want to cut spending below what Kevin McCarthy and Joe Biden had negotiated as part of the debt ceiling bill. Okay, that doesn't surprise me at all. They always want to cut spending. And when they want to cut spending, it's usually focused on a lot of social programs, but they want to cut spending on other things like foreign aid. But they want to increase spending when it comes to other things like construction of the border wall. So a sweeping GOP border bill that has stalled in the Senate, addressing the unprecedented weaponization, they claim, of the Justice Department and the FBI, in a nod, of course, to Donald Trump, who has been indicted in two federal cases. And then they also want to end woke Defense Department policies. Okay. And when it comes to the border bill in particular, they want to restart border wall construction. They want to significantly increase the number of border patrol agents. They want to restrict the federal government's use of humanitarian parole and make it more difficult for individuals to obtain asylum. And they want to enshrine the Trump policies of Migrant Protection Protocol, MPP, and Asylum Cooperation Agreement, ACA. And so they want asylum seekers to wait in Mexico while pursuing asylum in the United States. You'd have to work that out with Mexico, of course. And as far as I've been hearing, officials in Mexico are getting pretty tired of this type of immigration policy from the United States. And they want asylum seekers from Honduras and El Salvador to basically go to Guatemala as a safe third country to pursue asylum instead.
Yeah. All right. They're going to shut down the government, guys. That's the conclusion. And so, look, there's several stages of this. This is a continuing resolution because they don't have enough time to put the bill together yet. The final bill is going to pass theoretically in December. That funds the government. But if you don't pass the continuing resolution, you run out of money. So, and the government shuts down. So they're threatening to shut it down now. Normally they would threaten to shut it down in December. These are the games that everybody plays, right? And then is this time different than the other times? The answer is yes, and I'll explain more why in a second. But in terms of will they be able to shut it down? I think almost definitely. Why? The Republicans only have a 5-vote advantage in the House. And the House Freedom Caucus is, I think, over 40 people. So they have plenty of votes to block a Republican only bill. Then McCarthy would have to get the Democrats on board. I'll come back to that in a second. But why would the Democrats definitely not vote for this? Because of several things. One is the weaponization of the Justice Department is not explained, and neither is the woke Defense Department.
These aren't serious people.
Yeah, like, these are just, these are all just talking points. They never explained it, and presumably later, maybe they will put together an actual proposal to put the Pentagon back to sleep so that it's not woke. But I don't know how that's gonna work. I don't know if they're gonna do hypnosis, etc. But the Democrats can agree to spending cuts all day long because their donors also want that. And that's how the game is normally played, where the Democrats go, we're not gonna give you any spending cuts. And the Republicans go, oh yeah, I'll shut down the government. I won't raise the debt ceiling, etc. And the Democrats go, oh no, I can't believe it. Their donors and our donors agree. I mean, they made us do it. Okay, golly gee. So that's how this theater is normally played. And mainstream media comes in and brainwashes. They used to brainwash the whole country. Now they mainly just brainwash Democrats and into believing in the theater. And they're like, oh, wow, this is a new thing, a government shutdown, we've never seen it. This is amazing. Oh, this, oh, they got the Democrats, there was nothing they could do. They had to give in to these unruly, uncontrollable Republicans, golly gee. So I'm with Anna, I'm exhausted of covering that stupid theater. It's never real. In this case though, no, the Freedom Caucus wants blood. And they have a political motivation outside of the woke Pentagon and all that garbage, right? They want the economy to suffer so that Biden loses and Trump wins. It's not hard at all, it's not complicated. So McCarthy also wants that, but he's stuck between his donors and wanting to tank the economy in favor of Trump. So I think, so and he'll eventually go get Democrats, I think like in December or January or February or whatever the hell they get him, right? But in the beginning, the Freedom Caucus is gonna deliver on their threat, and McCarthy is not going to go get Democratic voters right away because he's worried about getting voted out by the caucus. So they'll shut it down, is my guess.
I totally agree with you. I think they are gonna shut down the government. And look, they want to cause enough damage where it hurts Biden, because if they shut down the government, and by the way, when they shut down the government, that means certain government agencies stop getting funded, which means certain services that people rely on will no longer be available until a spending bill passes, right? And so people are gonna get frustrated, and who are they gonna blame? Are they going to get into the weeds of how these negotiations happened and what kind of schemes politicians are playing? No, they're gonna blame the commander in chief, the guy who's in charge. They're gonna blame Biden. So that political motivation certainly exists. And one other thing I wanted to mention, because that wasn't the end of their demands. The other thing they're demanding is they want to oppose a blank check for Ukraine after the Biden administration's new request for billions in additional aid. In fact, on August 11th, Biden did in fact ask Congress for an additional $24 billion in aid to Ukraine.
Yeah, so now in the old days, and political reporters can't do any analogies or any examples that aren't at least 20 years old, because God forbid they should catch up to the modern days. But in the old days, when Newt Gingrich shut the government down, Bill Clinton said, I'll be your Huckleberry, go ahead, shut it down, let's see how it goes. And it backfired on the Republicans and it helped the Democrats. So the Republicans have been gun shy to do it ever since. And every time they threaten it, the reporters come out with, oh, you remember Newt Gingrich, right? But these are different days, brothers and sisters. Back then, first of all, Bill Clinton was good at one thing, which is he could talk to the average American.
Marketing, it's marketing, that's what it is.
Yeah, and he was a really good communicator, and he found a way, and he was totally right in that case. He wasn't always right, but he was right about that, to say, yeah, it was them that did it. And there was no question, right? Now, first of all, one of the differences is Joe Biden is a terrible communicator, terrible. So what he'll say is, oh, my Republican friends, you know, I can't quite give them everything they want, and but I'll take half the blame. And so then it'll get super cloudy, and then the Republicans now have a machine, a marketing machine they did not have in the 90s. Fox News started in 96, okay? They now have this awesome media machine. Mm. And it will roll out and it'll say, oh my God, they're sending all the money to Ukraine. It should be America first. And I can't believe how much overspending they're doing. And by the way, and here's another critical fact that I read about this. So when they shut down the government, their theory is, and I don't know that it's exactly right, but that a lot of the government over 50% easily will be able to keep going, and they'll only shut down things that they think aren't going to affect people that much. I don't know if they're right about that, but if that's true, then they'll go to the Vivek Ramaswamy talking points and say, oh, well, we wanted to shut down half the government anyway. Those are bureaucrats that are inefficient. And that right-wing media machine will roar, and Biden will do nothing to counter it, in which case he will get blamed for it. And then the Republicans think, win-win, how do we get this lucky? We shut down the government, our opponents get blamed for it, and our extreme base is thrilled because they think they're gonna get a border wall, and we're gonna put the Pentagon back to sleep, and all of these demands that we want. It looks like they're fighting for them, and they get a political win out of it. I would be shocked if they didn't shut the government down. Thanks for watching The Young Turks, really appreciate it. Another way to show support is through YouTube memberships. You'll get to interact with us more. There's live chat, emojis, badges. You've got emojis of me, Anna, John, JR. So those are super fun. But you also get playback of our exclusive member only shows and specials right after they air. So all of that, all you gotta do is click that join button right underneath the video. Thank you.